Rich Paul represents LeBron, represents Kentavious Caldwell-Pope. Max Kellerman, I asked this question facetiously only to make you laugh. What the hell is KCP doing with veto power on a trade? That's all you need to know. The fact that he can veto a trade.
Okay. So we're going to pause it there. I'm going to show you the next part and then explain to you why they're wrong. Take a look.
You don't need to be having veto trade power if you KCP. What's wrong with that picture? I don't know. There's only one reason he could have gotten that, and we know why.
Yeah, well, and also Rich Paul is the reason that KCP wound up getting $15 million for a year and then 12
17
million.
And then 12.
17 and then 17 12 million, but it averaged out $15 million a year last 2 years.
Their main point is, Robert Littal here, their main point is Kentavious Caldwell-Pope is not a good enough player to have veto power. Okay, this was brought to my attention on Reddit. And then, of course, obviously, like any of us should do in the media, you fact check it. And here is what occurred. So basically, if you have a qualifying offer, and whether you reject it or not, you then have a one-year bird right that actually gives you veto power. It is in the collective bargaining agreement. And there you go. For 1 year after exercising the right of first refusal to keep an RFA, the player must consent to a trade to any team, although he cannot be traded, to the team that signed him an offer sheet. When the player consents to a trade, his Larry Bird early bird rights are not traded with him and instead becomes a non-bird free agent. The player's consent is also required for any subsequent trades that season. So regardless, okay, look, I get it. There's a lot of nuances in the CBA that probably if we were asked some sort of random question, I may not know it, okay? I get that. But this is a big deal because what they have done in this situation is blame LeBron James. And it's completely out of his control. They blame Rich Paul. It's completely out of his control. They are given the rules and regulations. You follow those no matter what. I remember Jim Calhoun was asked some sort of question about, well, do you know the rules of this and that? He's like, it's 900 pages. Like, not everyone's gonna know, but we know the rules, obviously. We're at UConn. It comes with the territory that anybody, any agent whatsoever, what have you, needs to understand all this. So the fact that they are going and just blaming LeBron for having control and Rich Paul for having control, it's asinine and they should apologize because it's wrong.
Well, two things could be happening here. First off, when I read it, this was from Woj. Woj works for ESPN, right? So when I saw Woj said that, you know, KCP could veto a trade, I also raised the rock eyebrow to that because I'm like, why does KCP has veto power? Now, just like you, like I would think any normal person would say, I need to figure out exactly why. It's in the Woj article and why he has the veto power in a, you know, very simple language.
Wait, it's in the article?
It's in the article.
I didn't see that.
It's in the
That's
article.
That's amazing.
It's very simple.
Can I ask you a quick question?
Yeah.
Who's the biggest name for NBA media as an insider?
Woj. Woj and then Shams and then probably Windhorse. Then Stein maybe. I think those
Talk
are the
about
four.
A Mount Rushmore right yeah, there yeah, of insiders,
yeah, yeah.
Right?
I mean, those are the ones that I think you could trust.
I didn't see that it was in the article. That's
yeah, I mean, it was noted that it wasn't like in the sense that, you know, like LeBron has veto power. And I think Carmelo had it. It's not in, or Kobe had it. You know, it wasn't written into a longer term contract. So even if it wasn't, Woj works for ESPN. They're going to do a story on First Take. Either A, they know, and it's not a good story if you tell the truth.
Oh, I don't know about that.
Or
I don't know about
they
that.
Didn't know. Either way is bad because once again, you're not. I mean, they have thousands of fact checkers at
this
ESPN.
This one slipped through the cracks. Yeah, well, then again, even if they are a fact checker, this was live, so right. The fact checker could have easily got in their ear during commercial break.
But they talk about what, just like we talk about what we're going to talk about before. We get there. You give me a rundown.
We really don't, though, by the way.
But you give me a rundown.
I just send you an email that's right. Like, hey, here's what we're going
to
do.
But I would say, hey, what is this or what is that? You know, to make sure I'm accurate because, you know, the people, you know, the people watch me.
Uh-huh.
And they want to make sure I'm accurate.
Uh-huh.
So I don't know. I don't know if they just, it's just easier with LeBron and KCP.
No, that's it. That's it. You don't have to say anything else. That's it.
Well,
it's easier.
It's just easier.
It's easier to blame somebody. Yeah. Who is of the same ilk as LeBron James. Let's just be real about this. Like, If it was Kentavious Caldwell-Pope on another team, or it was KCP possibly going to the Rockets, like, are they even discussing it? No, it's because of LeBron James.
Now, you do gotta point out that KCP probably wouldn't have got the money that he's gotten if... I always say KCP was a mold last year for LeBron. I really honestly believe that. That was part of... I said that a long time ago, that, you know, he wanted to see how the operation worked, and KCP was the one that fed him back information. And then... I don't know if
idea if that's true, but all right.
That's what I was told. No. But I'm just saying, but you know, I don't think it hurts to be associated with LeBron.
No, it doesn't. It doesn't. Yeah. I don't want to steer too far away.
Yeah, don't steer.
By the way, let's drive slow, homie. Real quick.
I was moving my arm into his shot.
You're good.
You blew it.
Do you remember when KCP was going to get a max contract from the Detroit Pistons?
Yeah, a long time ago, yeah.
Oof, boy. All right, let us know your thoughts. YouTube.com/TYT Sports.
TYT!
If you made it to the end of this video, mazel tov. If you want to see more, hit the bell and hit subscribe. Why don't you?